At the supermarket, it's definitely difficult to justify splurging on different types of fats. One thing is for sure, and that is European-style cultured butters are more expensive than non-cultured butters. I wanted to know if European-style butters were worth the premium cost. As an aside, I was also curious to see how lard would fare, considering that it was 100% fat, whereas European-style butters range from 83 to 86% fat, and non-cultured butters range from 80 to 82% fat. To determine the value of this premium, I sought to find how each of these fats behaved in a baked medium. I chose shortbread for its simple list of ingredients and process, reducing the number of potential uncontrolled variables. Shortbread has a fairly high percentage of fat, making it a more largely weighted factor affecting the end product. Cubed cold butter is processed with flour, sugar, and salt in a food processor and pulsed around 15 one-second intervals until it resembled wet sand. The ratio of these ingredients are kept the same throughout all different types of fats. A side-by-side comparison shows that there are clearly differences between the doughs. From left to right, the doughs are in the order of non-cultured butter, cultured butter, and lard. The cultured butter is clearly yellower in color than the non-cultured butter, but their textures were relatively the same, moist with a slight crumble. The lard, on the other hand, had a very different texture. The dough is sticky, very pale in color, soft, and difficult to work with. The color of the cultured butter is much yellower because that specific brand of butter, Kerrygold, uses milk from cows fed with grass versus non-cultured butter, which typically uses milk from cows fed with grains. The grass attributes beta-carotene to the milk, which adds a yellow-orange hue to the butter. The lard I used was Armour's Premium Lard, which differentiates itself from standard lard by being preservative-free. It was softer than the butters at room temperature and had a porky scent. If I were to do this again, I would use leaf lard, which is a fat that surrounds important organs of the pig because it has a much milder flavor. But because it is much more difficult to acquire, I settled with supermarket lard. Leaf lard can typically be found at butcher shops and farmers markets. The cookies made with the different butters turned out fairly close. The one made with cultured European-style butter was crisper and darker than that of the non-cultured butter. But that's difficult to confirm, considering that there may have been hot spots in the oven. Overall, there is no significant difference in the cookies made with the different butters. Save your money or spread that cultured butter on a crunchy baguette. What definitely stood out was the cookie made with lard. These cookies could not even be picked up without falling apart, even after I cooled and put them back in the oven for another 10 minutes. The cookies made with lard were crumbly, greasy, and had a strange, unpleasant, porky taste. Considering that lard is 100% fat and that butter is around 80% fat, the ratio of fat in these cookies was too high. Instead of getting cookies with a firm snap, the resulting cookies made with lard were far too delicate and greasy. Avoid using lard for baked goods where butter is a key flavoring agent, unless that porky flavor is desired. If substituting lard for butter, be aware of the fat percentages to keep ratios consistent. Stick with just using non-cultured butter for making shortbread and everything will be fine.